Dr. Vineeta Ketkar, a previous practicing family physician since 1991. This is a long journey of 37 to 38 years practicing as a family physician in Vishrantwadi. Over a period of last 20 to 25 years, I got deeply involved in science of yoga for maintenance of health. It started with my own maintenance of health, but later on, as I found out that there are therapeutic aspects in science of yoga, I was more and more involved in deeper study. And so we started two yoga centers, one is at Shivajinagar and another is at Vishrantwadi. Both are involved in educational as well as in clinical work. Educational being conducting yoga teacher courses and medical yoga therapy courses, and clinical being yoga for fitness, or we can say yoga for health and medical yoga therapy. And the society is definitely getting benefited because of science of yoga. Thanks to our ancient science. When we say yogic science, it is Ashtanga Yoga, combination of Ashtanga Yoga and Hatha Yoga. Ashtanga Yoga, as we know, has been formulated about 500 years before Christ, that is 500 years before BC, by Mahamuni Patanjali. When we coin the word Ashtanga Yoga, means 8 limbs, which are Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana and Samadhi. So it is an 8 limb pathway. Many of us feel that yoga is just asana, yoga is just pranayama, yoga is just meditation, so it is not that way. Whenever we have to consider the therapeutic aspects, we have to look at it from a broad spectrum point of view. So it starts with yama and niyama, which is a behavioral discipline. So how should we think, how should we behave? Yoga gives us a guideline for our personal life as well as social life. And then comes asana, which maintains our physical and physiological efficiency. And pranayama is energy maintenance. Pratyahara minds our mind. It teaches us rather how to mind our mind. And then of course, dharana and dhyana, which are important regulators of our cognitive function. So you know, we can say it definitely helps as far as the therapy is concerned at physical, physiological, emotional and cognitive level. So there are many, many indications. Yes, whenever we see exercise, we usually aim at fitness. Fitness is physical fitness, or we can, at the most we can say physiological fitness. So the whole body at the musculoskeletal level is definitely well maintained as far as the strength and endurance is concerned. And all the systems also work well, including brain of course. We know the endorphins are released and all. But I feel the story stops there. But the emotional part or the psychological part and maybe the cognitive part is not well taken care of by exercise, which is nicely dealt by science of yoga. And in that way, yogic discipline is definitely much, much different, and we can say it plays at a very higher level as compared to exercise. Practicing yoga mainly helps, as I said, at physical level. So it makes our muscles strong, joints very agile, all our reflexes become sharp, body is quick to respond to in the form of any reflexes. So musculoskeletal level, yes, definitely it helps a lot. Body balance is concerned, especially it is very important. And then at physiological level, so we can say controlling our hunger and appetite, our sleep and wakefulness pattern, digestion, cardiac function, pulmonary function, mainly in the form of breathing, and of course the brain function. So it helps at all systems to work in a nice, I should say, harmony. In physiology we call it homeostasis. So it definitely helps the body for homeostasis. Ashtanga Yoga, as I said, forms the mainstay of the yogic science. Hatha Yoga mainly deals with purification of body, that is cleansing processes and postures, and of course pranayama and meditation. Eventually rope and belt therapy has entered and Dr. S. V. Karandikar from Narayanpet, Pune, being his disciple, has further developed it because he is a practicing family physician, MBBS, modern medicine doctor. So he developed it mainly for the musculoskeletal conditions like osteoarthritis of knee joint and lumbar and cervical spondylosis, and he formulated it where we can say it gives a predictable result. And I have learned for 14 years with Dr. Karandikar, as well as I was a regular student of Ayurveda Guruji. So in a way, I have learned from both of them and taken up oath to spread it in the society. Yes, yogic practices are most effective in many conditions like musculoskeletal and psychosomatic disorders. And of course, yoga is a, I should say, a lifetime trait for a woman, right from menarche to menopause and even postmenopausal age. But as far as the therapeutic spectrum is concerned, I will say that yoga is most effective in musculoskeletal condition where one suffers from pain, either from neck pain or low back pain or knee pain as age advances, mainly because of degenerative conditions. And wherein, if the yoga is taught in a particular way or right way with medical aspects in mind, then what is to be done and what is not to be done, it definitely is extremely useful for avoiding painkillers and if started early, even to avoid surgery. And as far as the psychosomatic conditions are concerned, everybody knows that for systemic hypertension or diabetes or coronary artery disease, or say hyperacidity, chronic constipation, anxiety, depression, many disorders, we can say science of yoga is helpful. First of all, let me say yoga is more for health promotion. Like if today my efficiency is X, after 5 years my efficiency is going to go down. So with practice of yoga, my efficiency remains the same. So it doesn't go down. So it is as far as the personality development is concerned or efficiency maintenance is concerned. So it is mainly the promotion of health. First is maintenance of health, promotion of health, and then comes of course the prevention. Because everybody is subjected to lifestyle disorders like whatever I say, early degenerative changes or hypertension, diabetes. So this all can be prevented. But if there is genetic factor, strong genetic factor, okay, it can be well managed with minimum medicines. And of course, postponing the side effects, postponing the complications as much as possible. So in all the way, promotion, first is maintenance, then is promotion, then is prevention, then begins a palliation. Like I said, for pain, palliation is very important. Patient should be delivered of pain. So in that case, we say palliation. And in some cases, it is restoration. So it requires the spine to near normalcy.